Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question which says, express the vector A equal to 8i cap minus 7j cap minus 4k cap as sum of two vectors, vector B and vector C, such that one is parallel to the vector Z equal to I cap plus j cap plus k cap and the other is perpendicular to this vector. Consider two vectors, say vector A and vector B. Vector A is perpendicular to vector B if and only if vector A dot vector B is equal to 0 and vector A is parallel to vector B implies that vector A is equal to lambda into vector B, where this lambda is some scalar. So this is the key idea that we use for this question. Now we move on to the solution. We are given a vector A is equal to 8i cap minus 7j cap minus 4k cap. And we need to express this vector A as the sum of two vectors B and C. That is, vector A is equal to vector B plus vector C, such that one vector is parallel to the vector Z. So we can say, let vector B be parallel to the vector Z, where we have vector Z is equal to I cap plus J cap plus K cap, and the other vector is perpendicular to vector Z. The other vector is vector C. So this vector C is perpendicular to the vector Z, where again vector Z is equal to I cap plus J cap plus K cap. Now as we have that vector B is parallel to the vector Z, so this implies that vector B is equal to lambda into vector Z for some scalar lambda. Consider this equation, vector A is equal to vector B plus vector C, as equation 1. So from equation 1 we have vector A is equal to, in place of vector B we put lambda into vector Z plus vector C. So this gives us vector C is equal to vector A minus lambda into vector Z. The next condition is that vector C is perpendicular to vector Z. So this implies that vector C dot vector Z is equal to 0. Now we have vector C as vector A minus lambda into vector Z dot vector Z, this is equal to 0. So this further implies vector A dot vector Z minus lambda into vector Z dot vector Z is equal to 0. Now we substitute for vector A and vector Z, so we get 8i cap minus 7j cap minus 4k cap dot I cap plus j cap plus k cap minus lambda into I cap plus j cap plus k cap dot I cap plus j cap plus k cap is equal to 0. So further we have 8 minus 7 minus 4 minus lambda into 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. That is, we have, so here we have minus 3 minus 3 lambda is equal to 0. This gives us 3 lambda is equal to minus 3, which gives us lambda equal to minus 1. So we get the value for lambda. Now we had vector B is equal to lambda into vector Z. Our value for lambda is minus 1, so minus 1 into vector Z, which is I cap plus J cap plus K cap. So this means that we have vector b is equal to minus I cap minus j cap minus k cap. And vector c is equal to vector a minus lambda into vector z. Vector a is 8 I cap minus 7 j cap minus 4 k cap minus of minus 1, that is we put the value for lambda as minus 1, into vector z, which is I cap plus j cap plus k cap. This gives us vector c is equal to 8 I cap minus 7 j cap minus 4 k cap plus I cap plus j cap plus k cap. So from here we have vector c is equal to 9 I cap minus 6 j cap minus 3 k cap. So this is the vector c. So we have decomposed the vector a as the sum of vector b and vector c, where we have vector a is equal to 8 I cap minus 7 j cap minus 4 k cap. Vector b is equal to minus I cap minus j cap minus k cap. Vector c is equal to 9 I cap minus 6 j cap minus 3 k cap. And also we have a vector z, which is equal to I cap plus j cap plus k cap. And this vector b is parallel to vector z and vector c is perpendicular to vector z. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.